morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning. It's a good morning to be in the house of the Lord today. I am thankful that I woke up alive today. Some people wake up dead in their bodies, dead in their spirit, dead in their soul, but I am so glad that I woke up alive all the way around today. I am grateful to be in the house of the Lord once again. It is a blessing to come along with the saints and fellowship. Hallelujah. I'm glad to be here, and I'm glad that you're here. I'm glad that you're joining us online. I appreciate your presence, and so does God. Let's take a moment to go before the throne of grace. Oh, God, we thank you. 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 If that was all we had to say, it would be enough, because you've been so good and so merciful and so gracious and kind to us. So we thank you. We thank you for allowing us to open our eyes today. We thank you for everything you have given us, all the things, the material things and the non-material things that we possess. God, we thank you for sparing us. We thank you for new mercies. We thank you for provision, God. We thank you for keeping our families, God. We thank you for healing. We thank you for all things. Most importantly, we thank you that you got us to this place where the word will go forth. We ask that you bless our speaker of the day, Elder Dozier, as she brings the word. We ask that you bless her family. God, bless all who will encounter this experience today. And let us not be the same. Let us leave here transformed, inspired to tell people the good news that you are the God that you say you are. We ask these things in your holy and precious name. Let the people of God say amen. 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 Come on and give God a love praise. Yes. Come on, give God a love praise. Amen. Come on. Come on, clap your hands. All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands
amen.
Together.
Amen. Amen.
That's it.
Amen. Amen.
Y'all know this song. It says, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. It says be glad in it, not after it, but in it. So that means right now, let's rejoice that God has given us another day. Hallelujah. Come on, put your hands together. You know this song. It goes like this.
This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad in it.
And be glad in
it. Oh, this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day.
That's it.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
Let's say that one more time. Come on.
This is the day.
Come on.
This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made.
I will.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice and be glad in it.
And be glad.
Oh, 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 this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day.
Come on.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
I will enter.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
He has made.
He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. He has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
Take it up to the top. This is the day.
This is the day.
That's it.
This is the day that the Lord has made.
That the Lord has made.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad in it. And be glad in it. This is the day that the Lord has made.
I will.
will rejoice and be glad in him. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made.
Come on, I will enter.
I will enter his gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter his courts with praise. I will say this is the day that the Lord has made.
I will rejoice.
I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
Oh, he has made me glad.
He has made me glad. Oh, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad. He has made me glad. Oh, he has made me glad. I will rejoice, for he has made me glad.
One more time. This is the day.
This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made, that the Lord has made.
I will rejoice,
I will rejoice and be glad in it, and be glad in it. Oh, this is the day that the Lord has made, I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made.
That the Lord has made.
That the Lord has made.
That the Lord.
That the Lord has.
Come on, say it one last time.
That the Lord has made.
Come on, put your hands together. Come on. Come on, come on, saints. Come on. It's the day that the Lord has made, and it's also a day to be free. Wave your hands if you're a free worshiper today. This song talks about being free to give God praise. It's a blessing. I'm glad I'm able to do it. Amen. Here we go. Listen.
Free to dance and sing, free to lift my hands and worship, Lord, I'm free, Lord, I'm free. Free to dance and sing, free to lift my hands and worship, Lord, I'm free, Lord, I'm free. Free to dance,
free to dance,
oh, 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 oh.
Free to lift my hands and worship, yeah, yeah. Lord, I'm free.
Lord, I'm free.
Free to dance.
Free to dance and sing. Lord, free to lift my hands and worship. Lord, Lord, I'm free.
Lord,
Lord, I'm free.
Free worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
Free worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a free worshiper.
Lord,
free. Lord, I'm free.
Free worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
Free.
I'm a free worshiper.
Free, free,
I'm a free,
free
worshiper.
Oh,
Lord, I'm
now
free.
You say it. Free to dance. Come on.
Free to dance.
Free to lift my hands.
Free to lift my hands.
Lord, I'm free.
Lord, I'm free.
Oh, Lord.
Lord, I'm free.
Free to dance.
Free to dance.
I'm a free worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
Lord,
Lord, I'm free.
My favorite part of the song. Listen. Hey. I thank God I'm free, and I'll never be bound again. Think about what I said. I thank God I'm free. I'll never be bound again. You ought to say that. You ever been bound by something? Come on.
Thank God I'm free.
Nothing can hold my praise back. Nothing can stop me from giving God the praise. Nothing can keep me from saying hallelujah. Whatever I've been through, it's behind me. I'm above it now. And I can give God the praise. Come on. Come on. Come on.
free worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
Lord, I'm free.
Lord, I'm free
worshiper.
I'm a free worshiper.
I can wave my hand.
I'm a free worshiper.
I can lift my hand.
I'm a free worshiper.
I'm glad about it.
Lord, I'm free.
Lord, I'm free.
Lord, I'm free.
Lord, 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 Lord. Come on and wave your hands. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. I don't know about you, but I'm free. I'm free, and I'm glad that God has taken care of business. And it's because of who God is that we praise the Lord the way we do.
I worship you, Lord. Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise.
Say, Mimi, yes, God.
Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are.
Because of who you are, I give you glory. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Lord, I worship you because of who you are. Jehovah Jireh,
my provider.
My provider.
Jehovah Nissi.
Jehovah Nissi.
Lord, you reign.
Lord, Prince of Peace,
and I worship
and
you,
I worship you because because of who you are. Because of who you are, I give you praise. Because of who you are, I will lift my voice and say, Lord, I worship you. Because of who you are. Because of who you are.
You see, you're Jehovah,
the Jireh,
my provider,
my provider,
Jehovah Nisi,
Lord, you
reign, Lord, you
reign
in victory,
Jehovah Shalom.
You are
my Prince of Peace.
And I worship you, Lord.
Lord, I worship
not
you.
Not because of what you've done, but because of who
you are
Jehovah.
Jehovah
Jireh,
my provider.
You made a way out of no way.
Jehovah Nisi.
Lord, you reign, you reign, you reign, you reign.
Jehovah Shalom,
my Prince of Peace, yeah.
My Prince of Peace.
And I worship you, Lord.
I worship you because of who you are.
I love to worship.
And I worship you.
I was born to worship.
Of who you are.
Because of who God is, amen. If you love the Lord, just wave your hands. Just wave your hands. Just wave them, hallelujah. Just wave them. God needs a hello, too. It's okay to just wave your hands, amen. Well, we're here, and it's welcome time. If this is your first time at First Fellowship, you can wave or stand or whatever you feel led to do. Everybody here been here before? Well, I'm sure there's somebody. Oh, hey, Nolan Mama. That's Nolan Mama. What's your name, sweetheart? Hey, Ashley. How you doing, girl? How you doing? This is Nolan's mom. You heard so much about you. Glad to finally meet you. And thank you for coming to the service with us. There's a gentleman, young gentleman in the back. There's a couple of gentlemen in the back that I'm seeing. I think I've seen the young man here a few times. What's your name, sir? I know your name, Nolan. We're talking about the handsome gentleman in the back row. He's come a few times, but he got that big smile on his face today. I'm so glad to see that smile. What's your name, sir? Devin. Hi, Devin. How are you? Welcome to coming. Thank you for coming to First Fellowship today. And I believe Elder has some visitors with her. She has her husband and brother-in-law. Thank you for coming, brother-in-law and husband. We're glad to see you. We're glad to see everybody. We're glad for the people who are watching online. Thank you for tuning in, stopping and putting your coffee down for a minute. We are blessed to have you here. This is good soil. This is a good place to be. The fellowship is good. The word is good. The people are amazing and so very loving. We invite you to come on in person when you're able, but keep on tuning in online if you cannot. We thank you all for your presence today, and I'm sure that God is pleased that you are here. So again, welcome to everybody that is here. And we thank you so much for taking the time on a good, beautiful Sunday to be with us. Amen. While we're at it, we're going to go ahead and wait for the prayers to load on the screen. If you have someone that is in need of prayer, please feel free to call out their name. say their name aloud as we display the name for prayer. We know we're in a world where there's always somebody that is in need of prayer. So before we go to the throne, we want to hold those names dear in our hearts, amen, as there may be someone. Yes, in the corridor, we have a basket for the offering. We also have online information for those who would like to give online. But please do not fail to bless the ministry, amen. So as you leave, there's a basket for you. And online, the information will be displayed, amen. So right now, let's go to the God of our understanding. The names are on the screen. As you are in prayer, just take a minute to look at the names and just pray with us, amen. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, the God that heals, the God that restores, the God that claims breakthroughs. We come to you right now, as humbly as we are able, knowing one thing, that God is able and able to do what we need God to do. God, you are in control. You are understanding of all things, the things that we don't know about, the ways you're making that we haven't figured out yet. We're on our knees and we're crying and we're begging and asking you to fix it. We know that you have already taken care of it. Is that God? God, we ask right now that everyone that is in need, that you meet the need, dispatch your angels to the situation, God, to the bedsides, to the bank, wherever you are in need, God. Show up, God. Fix it, God. Do it, God. In the name of Jesus, we believe that you are able. Just as the woman with the issue of blood, our faith tells us that if we can just believe, that it shall be done. Jesus said, ask anything in my name, and it shall be done. So God, we're asking. Not all the details. Sometimes we just can't say it. All we can do is feel it, God. But you said you already know. So go to where the need is, God. Go where it is, God, and please make a way. Lord, please heal, deliver, set free, whatever is in need, God. We ask that you do it right now. And before we can even say, I don't know how it's going to happen, before we can say it's not going to be done, do it, God. We believe and we claim it in your Son Jesus' name, and we shall rejoice, and we shall give you praise, and we shall testify and tell that how the world has been able to witness you being God. Bless us, bless us, bless us. Keep us faithful. Keep us testifying. Most importantly, keep us believing. It's in your Son Jesus Christ name that we do pray. And let the people of God say amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Somebody pray for me. Come on, let's sing that.
They had me on their mind.
Took the time.
They took the time to pray for me.
Aren't you glad they prayed?
I'm so glad they pray. I'm so glad they pray. I'm so glad they prayed for me.
Somebody pray.
Somebody pray for me.
Had me on their mind.
They had me on their mind.
Took the time, yeah, yeah.
Took the time to pray for me.
I'm so glad they prayed.
I'm so glad they prayed.
I'm so glad.
I'm so glad they prayed. I'm so glad they prayed for me.
One more time. Somebody pray.
Somebody pray. I'm so glad they prayed for me.
Come on, let's give God a hand for
you. Amen, amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Now, before we do the song of prep, I just want to say a word about our speaker for today. which is none other than Elder Debra Dozier. Let's give her a hand, amen. She is going to bless us with the word today. And so what I can say about the woman of God is that she is sure enough fiery woman of God. Every time you see her, she got a praise in her eye, praise in her mouth, praise in her feet. And you are going to be blessed by the word that she will give us today. I am thankful to journey in this space along with her, and I thought it not robbery that we take a moment and bless the woman of God. So if you could do me a favor and put your hand, your right hand in her direction as she prepares to make her way to the pulpit so that we can bless her. And everyone say, Lord bless, Elder Dozier. Lord bless, Elder Dozier. Lord bless, Elder Dozier. After the song of preparation, the next voice you will hear is that of our speaker, Elder Debra Dozier. Let the people of God say amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Here we go with this here. This here. Internet. Bless the Lord. Bless it, God. Hallelujah. There's nothing that can take me away from what I have to give to the Lord. We're going to sing about it just a little bit. Here's what the song says.
You, Lord, you are worthy.
And no one.
Worship you for me.
For all the things you've done for me.
Hallelujah. Things you've done for me.
And no one can worship you for me.
And no one can worship you for me.
So I say to God, here's my worship.
Here's my worship. All of my worship.
Here, God, please receive it.
Receive my worship.
All of my worship.
All of my worship.
God, come in and join us. Here's my worship.
Here's my worship.
All of my
worship.
Receive
my worship.
All of my
worship.
You got the words now. You, Lord, come on.
You, Lord, you are worthy.
And no one
can worship you for me.
As long as I am
as long as
eternal praise, eternal praise.
Breathing.
As long as I got in me, I'm gonna always praise you, God, for everything you've done.
Worship you.
Ooh, that's good. That's good. And I
will. I will.
moment to honor God on this morning, to give him all the glory and the praise and the honor that he is due. Hallelujah. There's nothing wrong with taking a little time out to worship the Lord. Hallelujah. To soak in the presence of the Lord. To just show how grateful we are for all that he has done for us. To give him all that honor and glory that he so truly deserves. Hallelujah. Just soak in the presence of the Lord. I know that's the testimony for us all. As long as I am breathing, I will not be silenced. I'm going to always worship you. Everybody just take a deep breath and exhale, blowing out every last care of this world and just allowing the presence of Jesus to just fill you. Hallelujah. Breathe in Jesus and blow out every last care of this world. Hallelujah. Reverently in worship unto the Lord, for he and he is alone, he and he alone is worthy to be praised. Amen. I am Elder Debra Dozier, and I'm standing here in the absence of our pastor, Pastor Tali Al Kenan III. We just thank God for him and his family, and we pray for God for safe traveling back home so they can be with us again on next week. Amen. Amen. I take it not lightly to be standing here in this holy place of God, to stand behind this pulpit to speak to you, his people. Hallelujah. That is nothing that we should ever take lightly. Good? Okay, thank you. I know she can always get on me for this microphone, so I said I was going to stand still today. I give honor to the head of my life, my Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. I give honor to my husband, Carlton T. Dozier, who is here right now. I give honor to all of the pastors, the deacons, the leadership all across the board. And like I always say, to Lottie Dottie, everybody, because we are all worthy in the sight of God. Amen. Amen, because we all want to live honorable lives before him. So I give you honor on today. Thank you all for coming out, and for those of you that are watching us through live stream, we just want to thank you for being here with us on today. Hallelujah. I just want to start off first by giving God sharing a praise report. On Thursday, I had cataract surgery on this eye right here, and I mean, everything worked well. I could see. It seemed like I could see immediately. I was like, oh, thank you, Lord, for taking the scale. You know, I once was blind. I thought I was seeing through those glasses, but now I see. And, you know, and then it was so funny because when we got here halfway today, I told my husband, I said, uh-oh. He was like, what? And I said, I left my glasses at home. So I thank God for the sight and the vision that he has given me. Because I can technically see, all righty. And this one hasn't even been done yet, amen? Amen. We praise him through it. We praise him before it, and we praise him afterwards. Amen. You got some readers? Okay, let me see what you got. Just yes, yes. Yeah, always got a ramp, just in case. Oh, look, and they match. I might just put these on just because they're cute. Amen. I'll use. I just come before you today. I'm not going to take very long. I just wanted to talk to you for a few minutes about one of the disciples. Because, you know, we all say and we all know that we are disciples of Christ. When we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, that makes us disciples. That means that we are going to obtain the discipline to follow him and all of his teachings. And this comes through our praise, through our worship, through our prayer, and through our reading of God's word. If you can just continue to do that daily. Secondly, whenever you think about a scripture and it pops in your head, a song that gives honor and glory to him, that's how we draw closer and closer to God. So in these moments of worship and adoration, you don't care who's sitting beside you, who around you, behind you, you just free to just worship the Almighty God. not only for everything that he has done, but just because of who he is. Amen. Amen. So I thank God. Start today. It's funny. I was all over the place, and like Pastor Leslie know, we normally do when we got a word, because we hear something one week and then it's God will flip the script on you and everything else. And Lord, don't let us try to lean into our own understanding, because he will cut that off with the quickness. Amen. Amen. Because I'm not up here preaching from the book of Dozier. I'm preaching from the book of God. Amen. So I just thank God for where he finally landed me, because I found out something, and I can only minister to others once I minister to myself. Amen. Amen. So we're going to start off in John chapter 1, verses 45 through 51. Yeah, you can, if you have the ability, please stand on your feet while we read the word of God. This is in reverence to God. In the book of Nehemiah, when Ezra opened up the book of the Lord before the people, they stood in honor of the word that they were about to receive. And that's why we continue this practice on today. Amen. Amen. John 1, 45 through 51. And of course, I'm going to use my favorite scripture as I read this. I'm going to do the King James Version. And so y'all going to get the these and the thous and the set of. But then as I go through and break it down, I'll make it more relatable, okay? Amen. Philip findeth Nathanael and said unto him, we have found him of whom Moses in the law and the prophets did write, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph. And Nathanael said unto him, can there be any good thing that comes out of Nazareth? Philip said unto him, come and see. Jesus saw Nathanael coming to him and said of him, behold, an Israelite indeed, in whom is no guile. Nathanael said unto him, whence knowest thou me? Jesus answered and said unto him, before that Philip called thee, when thou wast under the fig tree, I saw thee. Nathanael answered him and said unto him, Rabbi, thou art the Son of God, thou art the King of Israel. Jesus answered and said unto him, because I said unto thee, thou, I saw you under the fig tree, believest thou? Thou shalt see greater things than these. And he said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto you, hereafter you shall see heaven open, and the angels of God ascending and descending upon the Son of Man. To entitle this From Prejudice to Purity, and as a subtitle is called The Lesser Known Disciples. Father, in the name of Jesus, Lord, we thank you, praise you, honor, worship, glorify you. We lift you up, Father God. Right now, as I stand behind your holy lectern, Father God, allow all of me to disappear. Let nothing stand before your people but the Spirit of God that resides within me, Father God. I thank you for this opportunity once again, and I do not take it lightly. And our Father, as you have allowed me to be in trust of your gospel, let me speak these words that are pleasing unto you and not unto men, Father God, for you are the one that is going to try my heart. I give you all honor, glory, and praise. We thank you and praise you in advance for your movement and what you're going to do into the lives of your people. Let your people have ears to hear what thus saith the Lord. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen. Amen. Y'all noticed I'm saying his name the way it was in the Hebrew. It was Nathanael, and I think that's the modern day Nathaniel. You know, we just took some of the syllables out in there. But the first time we see Nathanael, his heart is filled with prejudice. Prejudice is a preconceived judgment or opinion. It is a bias that is personal and sometimes unreasonable judgment. Prejudice is a strange thing. Where does it come from? Why is it so strong? Are we born with prejudice? Yet, in the presence of Christ, we are transformed from prejudice to purity. Who was this man Nathanael anyway? Bartholomew is listed as an apostle in the first three gospels, And in Acts, John does not mention in his book Bartholomew, but he does tell of Nathanael. Most scholars identify these two as the same person. Bartholomew is not itself a first name, but it is a distinguished second name. It identifies a man by the name of his father. It means son of. So, therefore, Bartholomew means son of Thomas. In John's gospel, Philip is shown leading Nathanael to Jesus. Close friendship with Philip is indicated in each case. Moreover, Bartholomew and Philip are mentioned together each time in the three gospels. So Philip and Nathanael Bartholomew were friends. We don't know much about Nathanael, but when we put the several verses that we have right here in this place about him together, his character clearly emerges. John 1, 45 and 46. Philip found Nathanael and told him, "We have found the one that Moses wrote about in the law and about whom the prophets also wrote, Jesus of Nazareth, the son of Joseph." "Nazareth? Can any good thing come from there?" Nathanael asked. "Come and see," said Philip. My first point is Nathanael was a man who was seeking the truth. The way in which Peter put his announcement is proof of that. This shows that Philip and Nathanael had spent time in the scripture. They searched for information on what the Messiah would be like and when he would come. Nathanael was skeptical at first. He could not understand how anything good could come from such a poor, despised people who lived around Nazareth. You know, what he didn't realize at the time was never a better person came from a place on earth than Jesus Christ. But Philip was a practical man. He did not argue with Nathanael or try to plead Jesus' case. No, no, no. You know, he simply said, "Come and see." Sometimes you must know that a little demonstration is better than a lot of argument, all right? Nathanael said, needed to see this for himself. And sometimes we find ourselves in that situation. You tell somebody where you're from, and they say, "What? Now, I've heard about that. Nothing good can come out of there," you know. Or the ones that you knew before still don't realize where you are now, so they think that you're still in that hood, not knowing that that's where you were rooted and grounded in and grew from and expanded from out of there. And when God saved you, you left that behind. All of that mess and association that we were doing, we left it all behind. So don't worry about it. You know, when you're trying to tell somebody about Jesus and they're going to stand there and try to argue, do it. Never argue about religion or politics, okay? I think we've been hearing that forever. It's not even worth the argument. Just tell them, "Come and see." And that's what each of every one of us as disciples need to do each and every week. If every one of us would just tell somebody, "Come and see," we'd have double the amount of people in here on next week. Just one person. Come and see. Come and see what Jesus is doing right here at First Fellowship Charlotte. Just come and see. I know you may have heard about him, but you might not really know him. But if you would just come and see, you may be surprised. Amen. John 1, 47. When Jesus saw Nathanael approaching, he said to him, "Here truly is an Israelite in whom there is no deceit." Point two, Nathanael was a man who was sincere and without deceit. Jesus could see his sincerity in the presence of Jesus. Nathanael is transformed. Jesus says, "Here is a man who is completely transparent, sincere, and honest, a true, humble man." You know, it is so hard to detect sincerity these days. People work very hard to be politically and socially correct. People have been taught to hide their true feelings. How about us? If somebody was to ask another person about us, would one of the words they would use would be sincere? Would it be humble? Then the question becomes, are you sincere? Give you something to think about just a little bit right there. You know, when being sincere means being truthful, acting without malice or any kind of deceit in your life. You know, that we used to always say, and this in the words, a man's word is his bond. We used to just get by on the word and a handshake. And that was more than enough, because both parties involved knew that whatever we agreed upon, that we were going to make it happen. Amen? Amen. In John 1:48, and Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered, "I saw you while you were still under the fig tree before Philip called you." Because before Philip had got on the scene, Nathanael was sitting under a fig tree. And he was sitting there because he was meditating. Like we said, I believe there was a relationship between him and Philip. Philip, matter of fact, Philip didn't go to Jesus. Jesus came to Philip and called him. That's one of the few times that most of the disciples, Jesus tell him, come. But when he saw Philip, he came to Jesus on his own. Philip came to Jesus on his own. He wasn't like the other disciples when Jesus says, you know, follow me. You know, lay down your nets and come follow me. Philip saw Jesus and immediately was there. So by that relationship happening, of course he was sharing the good news with Nathanael, you know, so he was telling him, you know, "I saw you are under the fig tree before Philip called you." Nathanael, he was also a man, number three, who was curious. You know, have you ever wanted to know, how does Jesus know you? This reveals to us that Nathanael spent time in prayer. In Palestine, many went away to a quiet place for their prayer. They could find it beneath a fig tree. Jesus tells him that he saw him there. In our lives, we all need to find a quiet place and go to God in prayer often. We need to go find a place that has no TVs, no radios, no telephones, or rambunctious children to interrupt you. We all have to go to our secret place, that you will grow in God. Because when you learn of him and he learns of you, just like after 33 years of being married to my husband, I've learned of him and he's learned of me. I can say that I know him. He can say that he knows me. I can say I have an intimate relationship with him. Like I can say I have an intimate relationship with Jesus Christ through praise and worship, through prayer, through scripture, and through fasting. Hallelujah. It is your secret place that you will grow in God. Jesus knew that Nathanael, the way that Jesus knew him was by the Holy Spirit gift of knowledge that Jesus had. In John 1:49, then Nathanael declared, "Rabbi, you are the Son of God. You are the King of Israel." It was at that moment that he recognized him as teacher, as master, as Lord, as leader, and the Son of the living God. Nathanael was a man. He was a man of devotion. Hallelujah. He was overwhelmed when he heard what Jesus says. This man knew everything about him. Nathanael surrendered and yielded completely. Hallelujah. When he discovered Jesus Christ, none but the highest was good enough for Nathanael. He held nothing back, but he gave his all to God. Huh? To be a disciple is to live a life of obedience to God. To accept Jesus Christ as Lord is to live a life of complete obedience and trust. Guess what? It's not really that hard to do. You know, people say, "Oh, I can't be a Christian. It's so hard. You got to give up this. You got to give up that." But I'm telling you, after a while, you realize that was not something that you needed in the first place. And you're doing just fine without it. And you trust in God. Hallelujah. You know, I trust him each and every day. I know I shared this with y'all before, but I trust him each and every way to keep me delivered. Because, you know, it just takes one slip, one slide, and we could all be back into the sinful world that we left. So I just thank God for his hedge of protection that he has around each and every one of us. I thank God that when you realize that Jesus knows you and you know this in your heart, receive that. Hallelujah. Receive that, because it is just Jesus letting you know, "I know your name. I know the number of hairs that are in your head. I know the plans that I have for you, and they are good, and they are not of evil, to bring you to this expected end, to me." Hallelujah. So when you hear the voice of Jesus talking to you, harden not your heart, but open up your door and allow him to come in, because all he wants to do is sup with you. All he wants to do is speak with you. All he wants to do is just love on you a little bit while you give him love back through praise and adoration and glory. Oh, God, hallelujah. You are so mighty. You are so kind. God doesn't mind us giving him his words back. When we upset,
Lord, what in the world's going on? And he says, look, I give you peace in every situation. God, I thought you told me that I would be able to walk a life of healing. Hallelujah. He says, I am the Lord thy God that healeth thee. There's nothing too hard for me. It's sometimes like that when we think that we are lonely and in despair. And he says, I will never leave you nor forsake you. He says, I am right there by your side each and every day, all the way. Hallelujah. I will never leave you. I hold you in the palm of my right hand, and no man can pluck you out. I thank God, hallelujah, for his staying power. I thank God for his keeping power. I thank him for knowing that he is the author and the finisher of our faith. He is the beginning and the end. Hallelujah. He has already ordered each and every one of our footsteps in this life. We have all been called to be disciples of Jesus Christ. So once we realize who he is, stand up and know who you are in him. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Give him your all. He wants it all. All. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You don't have to worry about nothing else. It's not going to say you're not going to have trouble, because in this world we're going to have tribulation, but you have to be of good cheer, for Jesus has overcome this world. So no weapon that's formed against you is ever going to be able to prosper. And any tongue that rises in judgment against you, guess what? You ain't got to worry about it. That battle ain't yours. God said, I will condemn. I will. Sell yourself out to Jesus. I'm sold out. Yes. Yes. It's really not that hard to do. In John 1, 50 and 51. Y'all like the way I'm breaking this down to make it understandable? John said, you believed because I told you I saw you under the fig tree. You believed? Like, Jesus is like, you believed because I told you I saw you under the fig tree? Man, if you believed just by that, I just want you to know that you will see greater things than that. He then added, verily, verily, truly, I say to you, you will see heaven open and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man. Hallelujah. If you just believed on me because I told you I saw you praying, if you just believed on me when I told you I saw you when you was crying out late in the midnight hour, if you just believed in me when you found yourself in the time of trouble and there was no way out and all you said was Jesus, if you just believed, hallelujah, just on that, I'm telling you, greater works. Jesus left it in his word, hallelujah. I don't know why we'd be so sad, not sad, so, I don't know. We can't get what God says. Greater works than this shall you do. That means that he's equipping us and empowering us to be the people that go into the nursing home to lay hands on the sick so they shall recover. He is equipping and empowering us to speak a word over somebody else's life, in a word of encouragement, a word that will lift your fellow man up. He is speaking to each and every one of us every day of our life, just to tell us, you are my disciples. And what I have for you, don't worry and don't fear. Fear not, or neither be afraid, for I am the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. He says, I will equip you and I will empower you as my disciples, as the followers of my doctrine. I will equip you and empower you to go out into the hedges and the highways and to compel men, women, and children to come unto me. Just tell them, come and see. Just come and see. Amen. Nathaniel was a man who had staying power. Staying power. Now Jesus told Nathaniel that he would see greater things. Whether it is Nathaniel or Bartholomew, he was one of the 12 apostles. He spent 3 years living with Jesus, witnessing his miracles and hearing his teachings. He was one of the disciples to receive the Holy Spirit. And he was one of those that was by the Lake of Canaan, that when he told Peter to pull in his nets, he was there at that time too. Hallelujah. After the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus, he and Philip did missionary work and spread the gospel of Jesus Christ. I heard all over Asia and places like that. And although there are several opinions about how he died, we know he died a martyr, and he died from a brutal scrounging at the hand of King Astyages in Armenia. Huh? And you know what he was scrounged for? You know why? For spreading the gospel of Jesus Christ, for not shutting his mouth, for not being silenced, for letting the world know that I will not be silenced. I will always worship you. And because of who you are, I know that it is up to me to spread the good news of the gospel to my fellow brothers and sisters, to those that are still lost, to that one that I see on the street corner, to those that I may meet in the grocery store, to those that we may see in the hospital, in school. Hallelujah. Don't ever think you're too young that God cannot use you. Don't ever think that you're too old that God cannot use you. Don't ever think that you are not good enough that God cannot use you, because he is going to equip you no matter what your circumstances or situations are to do his will in this world. Amen? Amen. Hallelujah. He told him that he died, and some accounts mention that in addition to the scrounging, that he was beheaded. But we may not know what his end turned out to be, but through this story, we know that he had character, questions, confessions, faith, and a future in Jesus. And so can you. Hallelujah. We know that through Jesus, we can have character, and we can ask him questions. We can make our confessions. We can show him our faith. And we know that we have a future in Jesus to bring us to the expected end. I thank God each and every day, hallelujah, for me not being so hard-headed when I got to that point in my life, when I heard him knocking on the door of my heart, that I opened it up and I let him in. Because at that moment in time, even though I needed him, I didn't know how much I needed him. I didn't know how very much my life needed to be changed. I just knew that I was down in a valley of sin, hallelujah, and I didn't know which way to go. And when you get down in your life to the point where you're so low, the only thing that you can do is just lift your head up, hallelujah. Hey, lift your eyes unto the hills, for which cometh your help, knowing that all of your help comes from the Lord. I just thank God for each and every one of you, because we are the disciples of Christ, and there is a dying world out there that is waiting for each and every one of us to make a difference. God did not tell us that we have to go conquer the world. He said, just conquer the space that I have given you, the people that I have assigned to you. Huh. You do that. You can be faithful over a few things. I'm going to make you ruler of many. But imagine if God said to you, Pastor Leslie, you're going to go out and you're going to speak to every nation in the world right now. That would just blow your mind. But you know what he's going to say? Pastor Leslie, I need you to go up to Concord. You know what I'm saying? I just need you to go up Concord. I just want to see if you're going to be faithful about going up there. And if you're faithful about going up there, oh, don't you worry about it, because we're going to Fort Bragg next. And after we hit Fort Bragg, don't worry about it. We're going all up and down the East Coast. Hallelujah. And after we finish with the East Coast, we're going to head to the Midwest. And then we're going to take the South and not only the North. And don't you worry about a plane ticket, because when I send you overseas, hallelujah, it shall be paid in full, just the same way that he paid the price for our sins. Hallelujah. Our debt was paid in full when Jesus went to the cross on Calvary for such a sinner as you and such a sinner as I. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As he dragged his cross each and every step of the way, he had already been beaten. He had already been scourged. He had already had a crown of thorns placed on his head, yet stumbling, he went on to Golgotha's mountain. Hallelujah. For he said, I have the need. I must do the will of my Father. Because he knew at any time God could have canceled it, but he knew that we would have still been in a world of sin. And as bad as you think the world is out there now, imagine how bad it would be without Jesus. Hallelujah, sacrificing for you and sacrificing for me. Hallelujah. They took our Savior and he carried his cross. Hallelujah. The ram in the bush helped him get there, and they nailed him to that cross. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And they crucified him and they raised that cross up. What they thought that they were doing to destroy Jesus, what they didn't understand was that they were fulfilling Scripture. Hallelujah. Because he said, because if I be lifted up, I'm going to draw all men sin unto me. Hallelujah. And because he was obedient to his Father and went to the cross, hallelujah, for you and for me. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. They say he was wounded for our transgressions and bruised for our iniquities. Chastisement of peace is upon him. And with his stripes, every last stripe that he took for you and for me, we are healed. We are healed. We are a royal priesthood, a chosen generation. Hallelujah. We are the disciples of Jesus Christ. Now, this Nathaniel, or whether it's Bartholomew, nobody ever says nothing about him. We know all about Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, you know, Judas, and all of the rest of them. But who knew anything about this man's life? And what God is trying to tell us through all of this, hallelujah, is that you may have started off as a non-believer. But when you hear my voice, believe me, baby, you're going to believe. You're going to believe, and you will become my disciple in this land. You will become my disciples. I just stop by to encourage each and every one of us that has already accepted Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior to continue to run on. Continue to run on and see what the end may be. Hallelujah. Continue to spend time in his presence. Continue to allow him to love on you. Continue to allow to you for you to love, allow yourself to love him back in the name of Jesus. I just thank God. Hallelujah. For he is worthy and he has called us to be, hallelujah, his light in this land. And a light on a hill cannot be hid because we shine so bright in the darkness. You just don't know who's looking at you and your life each and every day. Hallelujah. And you are the walker epistle being read by men. Hallelujah. You say, you claim, like, you know, I hate when people used to say, oh, I thought you said you was a Christian. Yeah, I might have said I was a Christian, but right now you just made me mad and I acted out of my flesh, but I'm still a Christian. You know what I'm saying? I know to ask God to forgive me. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we all sin and fall short of the glory of God. But I thank God that he allows us to get back up again, to continue to walk on. Disciples of God, my word to you from God today is just keep on going. Keep going. Study me and learn of me. I have assignments for each and every one of you. Hearken unto my voice when you hear me. And know that I will never leave you nor forsake you. And walking by faith, you shall not fail. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. That's the word of the Lord for today, y'all. Amen. Put your hands together for the Lord. Put your hands together for the Lord on today. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. If there is anyone here or in the sound of my voice who does not know Jesus in the free pardon of their sin, that does not know that once he went to Calvary's cross and he was crucified and died, they buried him in a pauper's grave. And he lay there, hallelujah, and they thought for sure that it was over. But on the third day, he rose again with all power in his hand. Hallelujah. He was no longer just our servant, Jesus, but he became our Savior. Hallelujah. He is the propitiation of our sin. He is the one that stood in the gap when death should have been the response that we should have been given. But he said no. He looked down through the sands of time and he saw you and he saw me. And he said, that's my daughter and that's my son. I am going to the cross on their behalf. Hallelujah. Because I know once they get to know me, their hearts will turn toward me. Yeah. God is so awesome. Third day he rose with all power in his hand. If you have not accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, it's simple. I always tell everybody it's the simplest ABCs. Admit you are a sinner. Believe that Jesus is the Son of God and that God raised him from the dead. Confess with your mouth, hallelujah. Confess with your mouth that you know that Jesus is your Savior. God just wants us just like we are.
No heavy requirements. Weak, worn, dirty, smelly, dressed up, dressed down. He says, just come exactly as you are. Thank God for a well house on today. Thank God. Father, in the name of Jesus, how your servant have stood here and done what it is that you told me to do. Not adding or taking away anything, Father God. Holy. Hey, God. But be obedient unto your spirit and to your voice. The word of the Lord for the people of the Lord for such a time as this. I thank you, Father God, for the encouragement that we felt today. Just knowing that there was a disciple just like us that didn't believe until he had seen, until Jesus spoke to him and told him that he knew all about him. We thank you for knowing us, Father God, and we thank you for calling us your friend. We thank you, Father God, for the sacrifices that you made on Calvary's cross. We thank you, Lord, and we will continue to give you all honor and all glory and all praise. For everything we do is in the matchless, mighty name of Jesus Christ and by the power of his blood. We give you glory, Lord, on today. We thank you. We praise you. Hallelujah. You are worthy, Lord. You are worthy of all worship. We bless your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Put your hands together for the Lord on today.
Come back to the back so we can just think, just get ready to dismiss on today. Everybody ready to go? All right. Father God, we thank you. Hallelujah. Let us go out from here, Father God, spreading your word and your gospel. Let us have a good day in you, Jesus. We give you honor, glory, and praise. Come on, let's go out here and enjoy this day. Don't y'all be hollering for football louder than you was hollering for Jesus. Amen. Hey, come on, let's go.